Okay, I'm recording now, recording my face. Okay, so ask this question. I mean, someone reflected to me that I use the expression, I pray hard sometimes. And the question was along the lines of, if God's omnipotent, surely I don't need to pray hard, you know, because, you know, that power is there. I get that. And I would say there's a few things that the way I see it, this is just the way I see it, which is that, it's like there is I mean, there are spiritual principles or spiritual laws, and there's what's called, I would call, divine mercy or God's forgiveness or a reprieve or a miracle or grace, whatever you want to call it, which can be invoked. But for me, there's also spiritual principles. So no action or deed gets done unnoticed, if you like, within the divine realm. So, and one can call on divine mercy, but, you know, for me, it's like, I see this as the complex laws, spiritual laws of the universe, as to how much grace and how much of a miracle can be brought in. Even the Course of Miracles does say there's no order of difficulty in miracles. That's true. But I would say from my own experience, I mean, it is a bit like the 12 steps. It's like, if I was binging on food my whole life, and just sort of pray for a miracle in the hospital. Why doesn't God just fix my body straight away, send me into bliss, and I never have to do any more spiritual work ever again? And that's all that's required, because God's omnipotent, omnipotent. So for me, that's the thing of like, I mean, sometimes that could happen. In fact, that does happen with some spiritual teachers. They just go into a divine state of bliss and they never come back out of that bliss. And it happens in a split second. I think for many, it seems like, I suppose probably one way to see it is the ego reinflates, or the ego is not sincere. So probably I see the answer now coming to me. So probably when I'm praying hard is because I know my ego is in rebellion. It's not a sincere prayer. So I do the tool to take out the inhumility, because I know there's a lot of defiance in me. And so it's known from prior experience that, you know, there's a lot of stuff in me, shall we say, beliefs and limitation and baggage. And so I know intuitively from my own sense that in order to pray the defiance and the insincerity and the lack of faith completely out of me is going to take a lot of work. I can feel, almost energetically, I feel it's a heavily charged thing, which my ego's got a lot of baggage with. So I'll intuitively do that. I think God could do it within a split second. And in fact, if I had 100% faith and no defiance, if you like, or ego resistance, whatever you want to call it, in a split second, that miracle would happen. But I guess it's just self-honesty. It's like in some areas which are not charged, I think one prayer is enough and I let go and a miracle happens. And in some I feel like, gosh, Sabir, you've got so much baggage in this area. I, to be honest with myself, I'll probably have to do a lot of heavy duty work just to clear that. You could say lack of faith, lack of doubt, too much ego investment and payoff. So I think that was actually the answer I wanted to say. If there's a sincere prayer without wanting to hold on to the payoff of what created it in me, I think a miracle would happen instantly, because there would be no duality, no separation. And so the infinite power and love and mercy would occur in a split second. So I guess it's just my own defiance, which I'm honest with. So I'll just stop.